Hello, we hope everybody's doing okay. We wanted to show you guys the ARDROIT 30 amp lithium charger. If you've been watching the channel, you know that we've been looking for a lithium charger. We just got done building the solar box, so we need a way to charge it. This might be the option since it is 30 amps. It puts out a good amount of energy and it does plug into the wall. So right here we have the unit. It's a nice aluminum housing. Looks like it's extruded aluminum. Right here's the power cable that plugs into the wall. Standard computer type style. Battery clamps. You get about 3 feet of cable with it. Nice battery clamps. They seem to be copper all the way through. They are soldered and crimped over, so that's good. We'd like to see a strap in between here, but for the price now, you can't complain. And these run down into an insulated big jacket, which is, what does it say it is? 11 gauge. So 11 gauge wire. The unit's here. Basically on the back, it's got a cooling fan. Transfer switch for 110 or 220, depending where you are in the world. This is for US, so it did come with the US standard grounded plug. This is a model AD1230, which is 12 volt, 30 amps. There's your AC inputs. Now this can do two type of batteries. Lithium iron phosphate, which is a LiPo4, this is what we have, and ternary lithium? Never heard of that, but that's another lithium battery. Again, 14.6 volts DC at 30 amps. Here's the indicators. Power on is one LED. Charging is two red. Fully charged is one green. And that's all you get. No power switch, so when you power it directly, when you plug it in and hook it up to the battery, it does everything automatically. So there's no switches, nothing you have to mess with. Here's the instruction manual. And as usual, when it's translated over into English, usually it's messed up. So we have 80, 20, 30, or 1230, sorry, which would probably be this one here. And that's 12 volt battery pack, max voltage is 17. It's kind of high, but 30 amps. And here's everything, 93% efficiency. It has all those overvoltage, short circuit. But if you're charging a lithium battery, you got a BMS, so hopefully that will take over for the charging. That's everything. Let's see, and then here we are. Less than 80% is red flashing, red LED on always. So that's what we have. We discharged the battery down to about 75%, so we should see one solid and one flashing. Those are all the instructions. Again, there's nothing you can really do but hook it up. And that's it. So with these clamps, you want to make sure that it's really, really tight on the battery. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to take the studs out and screw it down to where the stud grabs this area here, and we'll show you. Also, we want to shout out Jim at ARDROIT. He helped us get the battery, really informative. So if you guys need a charger, you know, email them, check them out on Amazon. Again, the link is in the description. So we're gonna get this thing hooked up and see if it can actually put out 30 amps. All right, we got the charger sitting here hooked up. And what we did was we just took the screw and made sure that the lip of the clamp is on there very tight. And we tightened the screw down with holding it in. So now this thing cannot move. It's in there tight. Same thing with this one. We put it underneath the nut, so it's tight. And right now we have 13.3 volts. And we're gonna go ahead and plug it in and see what happens. All right, we're gonna plug it in. We got one red LED lit right now. We have two red LEDs lit. So they're both solid. One's not flashing. And that's what it says on the actual box. It says both are solid, but in the instruction manual it said something about one blinking. But it's charging there. You see 29.8, 29.7, somewhere around there, which we can consider 30 amps. It's close enough. 407 watts. And it should take about an hour or so because we have 33 amp hours we pulled down. This is 135 amp hour battery. So it's just after 1 p.m., so around 2 o'clock in an hour, this thing should be charged. We'll come back and check on it. And again, there it is. Both LEDs are lit up in red. One's a clear color and one's like a frosted color. So we'll come back and check on it in about an hour or so. All right, we actually wanted to add in that we're monitoring the temperature on the terminals as well as the battery and the atmosphere. So if you look here, we're about 27 degrees Celsius on the battery. And let's see. So 27 is about 81 degrees or so, somewhere around there, 81. So that's the battery temperature. The terminal, the positive terminal post here is 82.6, and the ambient air temperature outside the box is 73.7. So we'll monitor those closely. The battery temperature should be close to the terminal output temperature, because that's right around where the battery temperature probe is situated. All right, we're coming up on the 1 hour mark. The temperature never got over 100 degrees on the positive terminal or the negative terminal while charging. And we'll bring you over to the voltage here. There we are. And we're at 98%, as you can see there, 4 minutes left. We're right around that hour mark. We had about 33, 34 amp hours we drained. Coming up to 14 volts. So we will see if the charger starts to adjust the amperage. And we'll check the voltage of the meter here as well and see how accurate this is. We got 13.9 on the meter across the battery terminal, so off by 0.02 volts, so well within spec.
as we see, the amp is just starting to drop for the adjustment of voltage. 14.10 volts DC, about 28.5 amps going in. So the amps will go down as the voltage is going up. It should be coming up on the termination voltage soon.
All right, and the voltage terminated there. So that's it. It charged all the way up. The green light is on, saying that it is charged. So yeah, if you guys are looking for a good lithium charger, this seems to be a decent model for the price. 30 amps pushing out consistently. It can charge all types of lithium batteries. The biggest thing is to make sure that your battery clamps are tight on there. Make sure they're locked in tight. And temperature was only around 95, 96 degrees. And we have a fully charged lithium battery. So we'll be adding this to the portable solar generator. So stay tuned for that. Hope this helps. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.